Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Cube, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to do a little conditional formatting in your smart narrative visual. Stay tuned. If you're finding this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date on all the videos from both Adam and this guy. All right. Smart narratives. If you know anything about smart narratives, you should go check out Justina's video where she talks all about smart narrative visual. Go watch the video and she'll get you up to speed. But what I am going to show you is I had an interesting requirement. Someone said, hey, Patrick, I like your smart narrative, but can you give me an up arrow or a down arrow so I can just quickly take a look when I don't feel like reading to know what the numbers are doing? I was like, I think you can do it. So you guys know what I like to do. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. I created a smart narrative form, and all I did was in the visualization pane, clicked in the white space of the report and clicked the smart narrative, and it rendered out the narration for me, right? It did some natural language generation, and I published it, and they were like, oh, this is so great, Patrick. Can we have one thing right here? And I start clicking right here, and they're like, right there after higher, we would like a little arrow that goes up and down. If it's greater than 9%, go up. If it's less than 9%, go down. I was like, well, I can't change it. If you use the smart narrative visual, you can't go modify the text. You can append to it, but you can't modify it. All right. But there's a way where you can simulate your own smart narrative and you can inject whatever you want into it. So all I did was I went here and I clicked the text box. Let's put it in a nice tidy space here. I love these smart grid lines in Power BI. Reminds me of PowerPoint. So then I just start typing because the text box is a smart narrative. You know, it is, you can customize it, you can add things to it. And so I was like, I need this value. So I clicked this value and I was just guessing. And I saw max total sales amount by year. And I was like, well, what can I use this to get the exact same value? So I went back over to my text box, click plus right here, and I type max total sales amount by year. So it's giving me some number right here, but that's not the number I want. But if I click save, exact same thing. So cool, right? And I say, let's see if it'll work again, because I need this 2016. So I click this 2016 year with max total sales amount. Let's go back over to my smart narrative, click add year with max total sales amount. Let's add it. And boom. If you don't need these customizations like I'm about to do, the smart narrative works great.
I don't know that.
She scared me. All right. You don't need to do any of this. Let the smart narrative do what it does. Let it generate the language for you and use that language in your reports. My report consumers came back and said, hey, we want to customize this a little bit. So that's why I'm going down this path. So I just went through and reproduced exactly what was there. Okay. I just went through and did this. I did have a little trouble with this one. The capability to produce this is more of a DAX thing right now than a natural language generation. And so I actually did write a little DAX code. I'll make sure you guys have a copy of this PBIX file down in the description below. I said description, Adam. I didn't say comments. Down in the description below. Instead of you guys watching me walk through this again like a cooking show, I actually just kind of reproduced the whole thing. So you can see right here, here's the entire text. But the advantage that I have now is this one was generated by the smart narrative visual. I can't go and inject anything. On this one, I can. I can just pretty much type directly inside of this, and it'll adhere to my slicers and all my interactions that I make on the report. And so what they wanted right after hire was an up arrow if it was greater than 90% and a down arrow if it was less than 9%, not 99%. So what I did was I created a measure. So I went on to my fact table, said new measure, said up arrow equals, and a very simple if. And remember I said I created a measure, percent change was greater than 0.09. So I started my double quote because I wanted to display this. I held down the Windows key and I pressed period. And then all my emojis appeared. And then I clicked this guy right here, the Omega symbol, and I start scrolling down, looking for some arrows. There it goes right there. So I click the up arrow, close this out, and close that out. And I repeated this step for the up and down arrow. If it's not greater than 9%, 0.09, don't show anything. Let me go over to my smart narrative folder and you can see all the measures I created. And you can see I have a down arrow and I have an up arrow. So I created those already. And all I need to do is come right here, add a value, just start typing up arrow display. There you go. I'm gonna give this a name and I'll show you why in a little bit. Up arrow display. We'll click save. So it doesn't show anything. It doesn't meet the 9% condition. So I'm gonna go ahead and do this again and say down arrow. There it goes, down arrow display, down arrow display, click save, and then boom, you can see the down arrow because it is less than 9%. The reason I named them, if I go to review, I can actually see the things that I added. And if I want to edit them or change them or do other things with them, I can quickly see them. So now when I click away, and now if I select other years, you'll see it switch. So you see how the arrow switched? If I get rid of 2019, the arrow will go down. That's just because of the logic in my DAX, and it just kind of works. But of course, when I published this out, they were like, oh, nice, Patrick, you're so smart. Can you make the up arrow green and the down arrow red? It's like, So I did, I thought about a lot of different things. I was gonna use some conditional formatting, you know, in the elements, but that doesn't work with the smart narrative. So how did I solve the problem? Check this out. So what I did was I clicked in the text, I selected the down arrow, went here and chose red. And then I selected the up arrow and I went here and I selected green. And now when I click away, you can see there's my red arrow cause it's going down. And there's my green arrow cause it's going up. It's so easy, so elegant. It does require a little DAX, but not too much. All right, what do you guys think? Are you using the smart narrative? I'd love to know. Second, are people asking for these types of customizations? You guys know what to do. Let's continue the conversation where? In the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, give me a big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.